So let's talk about the Antichrist and the rapture. What happens? According to the Bible in 2 Thessalonians, there must be a falling away and the man of sin that has to come first. And that man of sin will come and then he will deceive people. He will succeed to seduce, to deceive a part of the church according to the Matthew chapter 25. And by doing so, he will be able to split the church basically in two. There will be the wise version and the foolish version. By through his deception, part of the church will miss the rapture and part of the church will go into the rapture. So that will be the first phase of the work of the deceiver, the man of sin. In the first place, in the first phase, he will play the role of a nice person, doing good to the church, being nice to Israel and to the church. That's the way he will succeed to deceive. Then after the rapture, that man of sin, the devil, will enter into the second phase. In that phase is the phase of violence, the phase of fury, the phase of madness. In that phase, he's not gonna play nice because he will know that he has been discovered. Everybody will know that he is the deceiver. People will not want to follow him. So he will use force. To use the force, then he will come with a mark to stick upon the people that follow him. That is when the mark of the beast comes into play. That is when he starts sticking upon the people, that mark. What is that mark? The Bible speaks about that symbol of a mark on your hand and your forehead. Please remember, the vaccine is not going on your hand, not on your forehead, it's on your shoulder. So the mark on the beast is not a vaccine. What is the mark on your hand? The mark on your hand means your participation, your work, your contribution into the work of the Antichrist. If you participate, you will be welcome. The mark on your forehead is your confession, your declaration, your commitment, your mind that you put in his work. That is the other one that's called the mark on your forehead. So if you are the one who contributes with your mind, with your thoughts, with your confession, with your declaration, with your work, by doing so, you are welcomed. If you don't do that, then you will be persecuted by the devil. That is the mark of the beast. It's not the vaccine. The vaccine is made by people like you and me. It's made by people to try to help each other. It has nothing to do with the mark of the beast. We take vaccines every day, and that vaccine is done by men every day. We take medication every day, made by the same companies that make the vaccine. So the vaccine is not the mark of the beast. The mark of the beast, just as we said it. Amen. May God bless you.